too salty.
Unless we need videotaping eating, we're not talking.
What? He asked me a question, I responded.
No, I'm asking if we have to videotape over here.
I can't hear you.
Do we have to be videotaped?
Yes, you're a public meeting.
How do you feel about all then the Department of Armed Services came down and said, well, the dam is safe to repair, it needs to be fixed or removed. You guys, the Lake Association, take on that liability and that cost. It's all you, because he's one of the subs you're about. You know, didn't happen.
That's correct.
And actually, no one's walked away from it, and the Department of Armed Services actually just sent us a letter stating that they're taking over a bunch of other things. When it comes to opening up the wall, people's lives are changing.
And you also have to know what you're going to get when you buy a company. If anything can change about it.
Obviously.
You've got mud flats now for a year.
You just need it, because now you don't have to throw it. Every person that makes a run out of boat, every person that makes a stand is free.
He
channel by the moment. Yeah, it's a bunch of those things. I feel like you're gonna like, it's a natural way to put it, right? It's a high level of the natural, also shaped.
Grady?
Yeah, it's a deep one. Yeah, salmon.
Maybe a short way down, and I'd say you're trying to encourage a higher pay.
I keep meaning to go up there in the summer, I haven't made it yet. I had some like taking points. Go through that.
I grew up there, like, I can't get it.
Yeah, I got it.
The last 3 years we've been discussing trying to how to fix it.
we took what we had and built them.
No, you have to create a brain somewhere.
You did.
So you try and find people and fake a way to do it.
Does RTF do something?
Yeah.
appeal to him was, because I did go to the legislature today for that subcommittee, and George went up as well. The last part of my appeal to him was, you know, what can New Hampshire do for us? You know, I said, the easy answer is money. You know, give town money to try to do this, but I said, a lot of times that's difficult to do. What town you pick, how you, you know, how do you split a $5 bill amongst all the towns? I said, the best option, in my opinion, is putting that $5 into NRRA's pocket, because they'll give us $5 and we'll spend that $5 just one time. If they give $5 to NRRA, they'll take that $5 and use it for training amongst a whole group of towns. So all the towns can benefit from that same $5 bill. So, I mean, I think they thought it was a half decent idea. So it was just a, you know, an easy way to get them to listen and, once again, think outside the box, think outside the narrow donation. The narrow funding. So, whether they will or not, right. I sat down between Thursday and this morning, come up with a bunch of bullet points just to, so I could stay on task. There were about three or four folks ahead of me that got out, and through their different process of what they do, and probably three quarters of my bullet points were exactly what they were talking about. So, wherever you want to ask it, everyone's on the same wavelength as far as what's needed. You know, better ways of coming up with how to process the plastic. The plastic is the big one. Yeah, and storage. And that was one of them. You know, and a couple of other things that storage space for this stuff is, I mean, we can walk over this. Well, you've been over this. You've seen what we have over there in the Quonset hut. The Quonset hut over there used to house cardboard. And
electronics.
And that's all that was in there. So now we have the cardboard and electronics. We've added the available to mixed paper, and we've added the plastic. And it's probably, it's like five bales of plastic sitting outside on a cover of the bag.
That's already
done. It's already available, ready to go. You have to have, excuse me, what did I say, 30?
Yes. And we have at least 30. We like to send out, you know, when you request a truck,
yeah,
they send you a semi,
and you're going to pay like a fill. Yeah. You're going to pay $400 for trucking. You want to send that full, not half full. Mm-hmm. So we've been doing this just shy of a year now. We started, I think, the second week of January, and we're up almost to truckload. So storage is a big deal. Yes. And as we have a little
out of the sun. Out of the sun.
Yeah.
You're saying for plastic.
Yeah. 6 months.
Of course, paper and cardboard is bringing in,
and you can't get it wet because once you get it, it's going to be trash.
Yeah. So, and if you look at what I got over there, I've gotten as creative as I can get to get that stuff in there. Because one of the problems with the mixed paper is in a big cardboard box. I tried stacking it once, and it didn't work. So you can't
stack it. Up
to the pretty side.
Yeah,
you can't stack
it. Yeah.
Yeah, so we can't stack it. So we've got two rows, single high. Everything else I can stack two to three high. Yeah, the paper, the cardboard is three high, the plastic is two high. And only, I stopped that high only for safety. It just be a little, you know, you get four high with a cardboard that you're looking at some problems. So, I mean, we got all kinds of ceiling space up there, but I can't use it.
But we can't get it out there either because we don't know what we have as a skid steer. We don't have a forklift. And it doesn't play as boring. A forklift would be one of those wish list items. You know, if I came across a good used one somewhere and be able to confiscate it, okay. But
even then, with a forklift.
Yeah,
a forklift, then you need the right kind of tire. Right? You can't have factory type tires, outside tires on what's on the skid steer in order to make it work together. Plus, I couldn't use it out in the yard at all beyond the pavement because it's so low to the ground. any pumps yet, or any, you know, you end up with a stock up. So really, for us, the Bobcat is really the best. Of course, the other thing we have is out there that we really need to get under cover are tires. They're supposed to be undercover because you hold water, and you know what happens when you have stuff with water in it. So, but as it is right now, we don't have another choice. The other problem I'm having is people are dropping off tires without coming to see me. So I have probably 20 tires out there that I didn't get in. Yeah. Well, the only thing Ed and I talked about, have another one that will have a trailer, a tractor trailer, like the little one they have here, and with a locked door, then they have to come to me. But of course, they're used to that one area out there, so again, they try to get, they drive off and I can't run out to the regular person.
One set of the very shooting people actually have a fire on the truck.
Oh, yeah.
We're really going to find or hire that extra person. I put in an extra person here, and we had one for a couple of months. We had Noel, and we decided to go a little quicker. We do have a meeting with someone right now, and that I haven't seen his application for that.
They get a pretty good lineup at the top.
Yeah.
I think what I'm going to do one of these days, and I've been doing it on Saturday, I've been doing it during the week, is just one day that we're not busy here, and I can spend some time over there, I'm going to scan it again. I'll stop every single guy that comes in, look for stickers, and just get look for stickers as I can. Look for the stickers and make sure, just help educate you. Just a spot check then, you know? I'll be an over, you know what, for that day, but I don't care. You know, if somebody's going to do it, I know that what I told these guys, don't get into any acting with other people. You know, let them start off here with another thing, when you're line direction, and they'll take it from there.
Well, there's an obvious thing.
Yep.
Yeah.